everyone. So this is a video that a lot of you are going to say I should not make. Friend and enemy alike. So I want to start off by saying to friends, respectfully, I know you say I shouldn't do stuff like this, but my life is my life. You handle things differently than I do, and that's fine. You handle your life the way you handle your life, and I'll handle my life the way I handle my life. And as you guys know, I'm not one to do things the way everybody else does, which is what draws a lot of attention to myself, which is fine. So I'm just going to preface by saying, I appreciate your concern. Thank you very much. But please just let me do my thing. This video is more or less dedicated to lolcow. Oh no, she's talking about us! Ah! Yeah, I know. Because you guys are like, oh, I hope you're, what is it you say? Hovering? Or stalking? Or, I don't know, something. You hope that I watch the site. I've got bad news for you. I don't watch the site. However, I did recently see the site. And I'm making this video now. And it's going to be a long one. So get one of your little losers to jot down everything I'm saying for you lazy asses who can't be bothered to listen to a video. You're so lazy that while you can stalk my entire life from moment to moment and take screenshots of everything just in case I delete it, because, oh no, the world would end if I delete a video or a photo. Oh my god! Anyway, in case I delete it, you've got to have somebody doing the too long didn't read, too long didn't watch. Oh no, it's a 20-minute video. I can't listen. Get over yourself. Are you gonna fucking stalk me or not? If you're gonna stalk me, fucking put some effort into it. Seriously. Stop being so half-assed about it. Anyway, this video is to say that I know you guys are talking about me again. This video is also gonna say to you other people out there, I've said this many times before, and this is a prime example of it here. I have said, don't be too hard on yourself if you are getting bullied and you react. Because the people that say, if you ignore a bully, they'll go away. They fucking don't. It has been a year since they've had anything to say about me. Because I haven't given them anything. It has been a year. I've seen them on there, and I mean, you can go to the site. Just look up Raven Sparks, and you'll see all their bullshit everywhere. They're all over the internet, and all they do is talk about me. And even if you search their site, there'll be forums about other people, and they'll bring up my name. And it's just like, they're completely fucking obsessed with me. Like, I am their whole world. They've basically made a celebrity out of me, because they can't get over me, which is kind of flattering, but what am I gonna do? You know, I'm not gonna crawl into a hole and die, unfortunately for them. Anyway, I did not know about them to start with, so they're going on and on about me for years. I didn't know about them, that did not stop them. Once I found out about them, that did not stop them. Living a year of my life, changing everything about myself, that did not stop them. So, if a bully is obsessed with you in your life, or a group of bullies who have no life of their own, they're obsessed with you and making up stories about your life, it doesn't matter what you do, they will not leave you alone. So if you feel like you've got to tell them off, you've got to confront them. You've got to make a video having your say that they're going to listen to because they're nosy and they want to know everything you talk about. Then do it, because nothing you do is going to stop somebody who is completely obsessed with you. And I just want to say, this is really weird because my camera's right here, but my video is over here. So I'm like looking over here when the camera thing is over here, and it just like, if I look over here, then I can't see what I'm doing, so I look over here and it just looks like I'm fucking retarded. Anyway, so I'm gonna tell you how stupid these people are, okay? So I had said that I was feeling quite down and quite upset. Now that this is out, 100% honest, I was upset because I found out they were talking about me again. Like, I suspected it would happen. I hoped it wouldn't happen because I was like, I've worked so hard in the past year and a half or whatever in improving my life and changing myself and thinking about everything that they picked apart about me, aside from leaving my husband and getting my nose fixed or whatever. And I've changed everything that they've complained about. I've fixed my eyebrows, I fixed my makeup, I lost weight, I made up with my son. I've done everything, probably more than any other lolcow has ever done. And everything that they said, oh, if a lolcow makes an attempt to change their life, we'll leave them alone. We'll be really, really happy for them because we're not bullies. We just want to see people improve their lives. That's a load of shit because I've done all that and they've still, what's she doing? What's she doing? Is she still, at least she had to, I need to know what she's doing. And I've seen them dropping in from time to time looking for something and they haven't had anything. And now this time, somebody has been stalking me to the point where 9 minutes into a 20-minute video, I said something that I thought was nothing really bad, but they took it and ran with it. And that's what got them started again. And from there, they're watching all over my Facebook. I post me and Logan went with his grandparents to the mall because they wanted to buy early birthday presents because there was a big sale on, and boom, 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 all over that shit. And what they do, they're so full of shit, not even full of themselves, they're just so full of shit that they will take literal words that I say and change it. And it's like, are they really that stupid, that ignorant, that deaf, or are they in living in that much of a fantasy world that they can take complete facts and turn them into bullshit? And everybody on that site is a sheep, so they'll read it and be like, "Oh, she's a horrible person! Oh my God, did she really say that?" Without stopping and just checking their facts first. And it's like, okay. I said I was depressed because I found out that these faggots were fucking after me again. And I was like, well, I've done everything. Why are they still after me? I couldn't believe it. And it was like I'd been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting, knowing one day they're gonna come back. And when it happened, I wasn't prepared for it. And so I had a little bit of a moment of weakness. I mean, I am only human, and it is never a good thing to find out people are obsessed with you. It throws you back for a minute. So it just knocked me back for a minute. And before I regained my composure, and like thought about shit again and got my head back on straight, which was the very next day. But the first day I was just like I just feel so impotent because I don't know who they are and I never will because they're pussies. They've got nothing and they will never like front out and say who they are because that would spoil all their fun. So they're content with just hiding online and talking shit. And so not knowing who they are and not being able to do anything about it, because trust me, if I was able to get my hands on any of them, I would happily go to jail for doing something, whatever I could, to people that do this for fun. They deserve everything and anything that they get. Fortunately, I can't do that. So it makes me kind of go through some weird shit because I can't do anything to protect myself. I can't do anything to these people. Like, you hate me so much. Fucking come over here and just have it out with me. Just let me kick your fucking ass. And of course, they won't. Even if they lived next door to me, they wouldn't. And it just kind of makes you feel like, what are you gonna do about it? What can I do about it? Can't do shit. Oh well, just live my life. And so he told me if I did not take the presents that he bought for me for Christmas that have been sitting over there on that table. Yes, look at that mess, and that is all him again. But that table there by the fan is where they have been sitting for months. He said, if you don't take these presents, I'm not gonna go to sleep. If I don't go to sleep, I'm not gonna be able to go to work. And I was like, no, I don't want to take them. And I've said this before, but you know, this is for people that don't know how to listen. So finally, because he kept on, just take it, just take it. He was actually getting angry with me because I kept telling him, no, it'll make you happy, just take it. So I took it, opened the presents. It was the dress and the necklace. I love them. And I explained exactly what happened, leaving out the fact that I found out that these fuckers were on my shit again. And they said, oh, she forced him to buy her presents or give her presents because she's guilt tripping him because he's working and he's saving money so that he can leave her. And it's like I said in my video, that I was feeling vulnerable and like I was losing the relationship. Doesn't mean it was real, it just means that's how I was feeling when I said, when I made the video. It was a 50 questions Q&A thing, and I let slip how I was feeling, and they happened to catch it, and they jumped all over it. And the thing is that Logan is a workaholic. That's a flat fact. He is a workaholic. He loves money. He likes to buy shit. He is addicted to Pokemon cards. He's trying to collect because he had thrown away his collection and he is starting from scratch again. So they're like $30 to $90 for the boxes that he gets, which is quite a bit of money. If he wants money to get the stuff, he has to earn the money. To earn the money, he has to work. He doesn't like suffering. He doesn't like being poor. He doesn't like being broke. Since we don't leave because there's nothing to do in this city, he's like, why not work? If I can make money, I'm gonna fucking make money. And so he works. And because he snores, we usually cannot sleep at the same time. Doesn't mean we don't want to. It just means that we cannot because he kicks, he thrashes, he scratches me, he hurts me, or he snores. And if I happen to have an appointment or something the next day, I cannot sleep at night, so he has to go into the spare bedroom. This kind of sucks for our relationship, but it's something that we need to work on getting him to go to a doctor. As far as working overtime, he doesn't mind it, and it's not that he wants to be away from me because he doesn't. He's really fucking attached to me, whether you like it or not. He loves me, and I don't give a shit if you have a problem with that because he loves me, and you can just kiss my ass. Because you're fucking jealous and you think that he's too good for me, which is a load of bullshit because it's not up to you. It's up to him and me if we want to be together, not you. So you can fuck right off with that. You sit around and you hate my life so much because you think that my husband doesn't need to be with someone my age because I don't work, as if I'm the only person in the universe that doesn't work. And he has no problem with me not working. So it's like, why the fuck does our relationship bother you so much? He's not a child. He's not an idiot. He's not a retard. He knows who he is and what he wants. And you can't stand that because for some reason you've got a personal grudge against me and think that I don't deserve anything good in my life. And it's like, okay. Anyway, they took that and they take so much that I say and they'll twist it and turn it. And then like everything that I've done this past year and a half to fix my life and to fix myself, they're like, there was a video and her son said he would be happy to move out and she got mad at him. Yep, she hasn't changed at all. No, because the fact that I have an almost 22-year-old that sleeps all day, won't get on welfare because he doesn't want to have to go to meetings to help him find work, even if he doesn't work, just pretending to look for work. He's too lazy to take money from the government. He enjoyed being in a homeless shelter. He doesn't care if he's starving. He has nobody on this earth except for me. He leaves, throws a temper tantrum, and then comes back banging on my door, asking me to take him back. And I take him back every fucking time. But because I'm upset because I've got a son that's got not one single skill to help him survive in this world if I were not here, and I want him to have a leg to stand on, whether he chooses to use that or not. The fact is, if he had those skills so that he could take care of himself in his future, that would be okay. But he's got no skills. If I wasn't here, he would rot in a gutter somewhere. And if that makes me a bad mom because I don't like that, well then fuck me, I must be a horrible mom. Yeah, I was a horrible mom in the past. People aren't allowed to change. Seriously, I haven't said anything bad about him in well over 2 years, but they're using something that I said out of complete anger, like in 2013 or 2014 or something. I don't remember the year, so don't say, "Oh, you're lying." I don't remember the year, but I do know it has been at least 2 years since I've said anything. And the worst thing I ever said about him was that I wish that I had had an abortion because he doesn't care about anybody or anything. That's how it appears to me. And I had said, since he was the only baby I was ever able to have, I just wish that I had had a baby who loved me or who cared about themselves or who had some, aspirations for their future. I said it wrong and I said it in a very hurtful way. I took it back. I've more than apologized for it. But based on that sentence, I'm labeled by them as the world's worst mother. Yet, they have no problem telling me that they're glad that I can't have kids. They're glad my innocent babies died so that no living creature has to be subjected to my horrible parenthood because I'd fuck everybody up because I'm that much of a bad person. And it's like, okay, who's here living their life and who's there picking and picking and picking and picking and lying? Like, me and Logan go on there and we actually read the shit that they say and we just look at each other like, where the fuck did they get that shit from? Because they make up so much shit. It's like reading a fucking book of fairy tales. They have maybe 1 ounce of the truth. Like, for instance, me and Logan got married. Mixed with, apparently, I was in my mid-40s and he was 16, or somebody said the other day that he was 14. And it's like, okay, or that, yeah. He was not 16 when we got married. He was 18 when we got married. And I'm not even 40 yet. Yeah, I'm gonna be 40. Oh, and I look so bad for my age. But I have so many people that tell me constantly I look nowhere near my age. Oh, and then they rag on me because I'm so old, but I dress gothic. Because of course they can't just say gothic, they have to spell it like a fucking retard because that's probably the way they think it's spelled. Even though I'm not goth, I don't consider myself goth. I'm me. I do what I want to do because I want to do it. I don't label myself. They label me. I only say goth just to make it easy if I'm trying to give a quick answer because there's no reason to get into it with anybody. But I don't really have a set style. I've been doing the rockabilly kind of look for the last couple of months because of my saggy stomach from the weight loss. And I've worn skinny jeans because I can fit into them now. I like gowns, I like skeleton stuff. I'm wearing a fucking Batman shirt. I don't even like Batman. Logan bought this for me, and so I wore it. Casual, not casual. I just wear whatever, I do whatever. And I don't appreciate being labeled as a gothic old lady. But yet, it's okay for Adora Bat Brat, who is older than me. Who has like Titty Tuesday or whatever, where she shows her tits. I mean, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with what she's doing. It's her life. She's got her kids, she's got her husband, whatever. What I'm saying is that it's just really fucked up because they all love Adora and they'll never say anything about her or anybody else. It's completely fine for them. It'll be fine for her, Black Friday, for instance, Freya. She's not as old as me, but she's not a teenager either, and she goes way overboard as well. They'll never say anything bad about her or any of these chicks. None of them. And they could be in their 40s or later and compare me to a Dora Bat Brat, and it's like I'm not wearing makeup because she goes, I mean, everybody knows who she is, but if you don't, she goes completely overboard with the swirls and the eyebrows and the gems and all that. But that's okay, even though she's older than me and she goes way over the top. But yet they say that I go way over the top and I'm way too old to be looking like that. And it's like, you're how old and you dress like a Hot Topic reject? One, I used to love Hot Topic, so that's not an insult to me. Two, who cares? I dress how I dress because I want to dress like that. Three, age doesn't fucking matter. I happen to look up to the older people that you see, 60, 70, 80-year-old people still looking alternative because you know what? They've got style and they fucking know it. And you know what? If I stopped dressing like this, then they'd be on my ass saying, oh, what a fucking poser. Yeah, look at her. She was in it for how long now? You know, a true goth would never grow out. It's like, oh, you can't win. You just can't win with them. And then they say, you know, apparently I'm still fat, even though I'm not. I'm slightly above average or around average. I'm about a size 10. So I fit into mediums, I fit into smalls, but I'm still fat, right? Since they can't pick on my weight as much anymore, they can't say like the whale or whatever, they pick on the pedophile shit because of course the age gap's never gonna go away. Now they expect me to get plastic surgery to get rid of my nose because they hate my nose. They hate my nose, so they expect me to do something about this disgusting big blob that's in the middle of my face. I hate my nose as well. But you know what? I was born with it. I'm Asian. I've got big Asian nostrils. I have a big Asian nose. If you don't like it, why don't you fucking PayPal me some money and I'll happily go and get this taken care of. You don't like it, fucking pay for it. You don't want to pay for it, then shut the fuck up. What do you look like? Oh, that's right. You're a pussy and you'll never show me. Anyway, we all make mistakes in life. We all have our good days and our bad days. The mark of a good person is how much you are willing to acknowledge and accept that you've been a bad person in your past and you make steps to fix that. I am quite confident that I've done everything in my power to make steps to be a better person. They don't want to see me as as a better person because it won't give them anything to talk about. So, honestly, okay, this is how I feel about the lolcow situation, 100%. First, when I first found out about them, I was devastated. I was so upset. I cried all the time. I wanted to die. I really wanted to kill myself. Go on and say, wah, you always want to die. I don't care if you don't believe me. I wanted to fucking die. Because I felt like no matter what I did, they'd always be on me. And finding out that many people hated me and had a problem with me, it was overwhelming to me. And as it was, I hated myself. I had doubts about myself. I didn't think I was good enough for my husband. I didn't think I was a good mother. I didn't think I was a good anything. I didn't think I had anything to offer in this world. And they fed on every single flaw I saw in myself, they talked about. And so I was just seeing things I already hated echoed. You know, by them. And I really couldn't fight against that. So then I hid. I got offline, shut everything down. I just wanted to take a step away. When I did that, another group made a page, some or another group, another person, I don't know who, of course, they made a page on Facebook saying that I had killed myself. And I became aware of this page because everybody started writing me and Logan and Dorian, finding out if I was really dead and what had happened. And I decided to leave the page alone because I wanted them to think I was dead. And it's funny too because I had actually tried to kill myself, not fully because I wouldn't be here, but I had attempted to. I ended up being taken by the police to the hospital for evaluation. Because Logan called the cops on me because I had told him when he was at work that I wanted to kill myself and I couldn't take it anymore, and he was scared for me, and so he called the cops. And because the cops came and it was a suicide threat called in by somebody else, they couldn't leave, they had to take me with them. The cop was there. It was a female and a male, but the female was really nice. She was actually like the nicest female cop I've ever run into. And yeah, nothing happened there. I just said, "No, I was feeling sad, but I'm not anymore. I just had a moment of weakness." And then they just let me go, which is kind of scary because if I really didn't want to kill myself, they wouldn't have actually stopped me. And along the same topic, it's quite funny that lolcow, and I say lolcow, but really there's like lolcow, and then there's a forum, and they used to be called like kiwifarms forums or something. They change their name quite often, but there's like different forums and different sites, but I think it's the same people that just travel amongst the forums just talking about me. They're spreading my name all over internet land. Anyway, they always say she expects us to believe that there's people out there that hate her. I think she's making all these sites and stuff up herself when they're on a site hating me and talking shit about me. So it's like they're doing exactly what I say people are doing, and they're denying that anybody's doing it. Like, you see how fucked they are? Like, they don't make any sense. They're like completely in their own world. Like, they're not even in the real world. You've got to really pity them because something is just screwy in their head. Anyway, so I still wanted to die. And then when that site came up, I reported it and got it taken down because one of my friends, well, one of Dorian's friends, went on there saying that, he made the page because lolcow, when they found it, they said I made the page and started causing trouble for me. And so he went on and he was like, "No, I made the page," hoping people would leave her alone. He did that for me, as himself. But whoever made the page didn't like that. And so they wrote saying that they were me and I did it just to see if people cared. And my friends saw through it right away. They were like, "No, this isn't her. She doesn't fucking talk like that." And I was like, "Oh my God, you guys are awesome." And I went and I reported the page and I got it taken down. Lolcow to this day still thinks that I did it, but you know what? Who cares what they think, right? So then I got approved for my surgery, which to me was like the defining moment of my life. My life could have gone two ways. Either one, I was probably going to try to kill myself again because I just had nothing. I didn't see a way out for myself. I didn't see a way to change my life. I needed a like an anchor, something to kind of hold myself to and then work around that. And for me, it was the way I looked. It was my weight and stuff. So once I got approved for the surgery, to me, it was like my whole life just kind of opened up ahead of me. Everything just changed. I got the surgery, started dropping the weight, and started feeling my humanity coming back. When I first started feeling human again, I was making videos talking out about the bullying and the stuff that I'd been through because it was, to me, only I know how close it actually was. And to me, it was such a narrow escape. I just, like, it was like I got my life back. Like, I got the last 10 years or more of my life back. And, you know, I didn't want to slip back into what I was before. And so when I made my videos, I kind of fronted a little bit because I knew how I should feel, and I knew how I was kind of feeling, but I wasn't used to feeling like that. I wasn't used to feeling confident or strong, and so I had to kind of trick myself into thinking that I was stronger than I was. And so I made it a point to be like, "Look, you don't bother me. Look, you don't fucking scare me. This is my life, and I'm gonna do what I want to do." But there was always a little part of me that was still like, "They're they're still gonna go, they're still gonna go, they're not gonna leave you alone, just be strong, and I always had to be conscious of that. And as I started doing stuff, everything I did, I knew that they would be over my shoulder. I mean, you guys don't know what it's like to know that for the last, what, 4 years plus, there's at least one anonymous person that has been shadowing your whole life, pretty much. And with them, there's a group of other people. And everything you do, anything you do, could be screenshot and used against you. If you have a moment of weakness, if you word something wrong, they're gonna be on you. It's pretty intimidating, you know? Or at least it was. And so everything I did, it was like, this could be watched. You know, we took in that girl and tried to help her. And I was like, surely, you know, this is a good deed that I'm doing. And then she, just because I went online and asked for help, she got all butt hurt because somebody betrayed me and went to them and started this whole thing up. And instead of them saying, well, Raven didn't actually do anything wrong, all she did was ask for help on how to handle her, they were like, oh, well, Raven's the, she's all mad because this teenager that she took in acted like a teenager. And, And it's like, I had a teenager, and teenagers don't act like that. The shit that she was pulling was really disrespectful, and it was tearing my family apart. My family comes first, so, yeah, I asked privately for help, and she just ran with it the wrong way. And then after that, we took in two homeless guys that needed a place to stay, which also, good deed here, good deed. Are they going to see that it's a good deed and then I'm trying to be a better person and not so negative? Nope. So when they robbed us, oh, lolcow took the pictures of that and laughed, because apparently trying to help people and then getting robbed in return is funny. But they can't see the good deed. They just thought it was funny. So, you know, it went on like that. And slowly as time passed and I became more and more, you know, comfortable with myself, I started thinking about them less and less, and it got to the point where I didn't think about them at all. I was too focused on making my videos, doing what I wanted to do, learning about myself, pretty much reversing in time and going back and just focusing on nothing but taking my life back, taking back the last 10 years of my life and doing what I needed to do, living how I needed to live, and just trying to fix all the little holes in my life, you know, just so that I could be happy. Not for them, because nothing will make them happy, just to make myself happy and to make my family happy, because my family is all I've got. And I checked on the site once at some point, and I saw that they were trying to think of something to talk about. You know, they checked on me. Oh, well, she's doing makeup for people. It looks like shit, but at least she's doing something, that lazy bitch. Because for some reason, they're really upset that I can't find work here. And they think it's because I've got a couple of tattoos on my face here. Oh, I'm such a dumb bitch for doing that. Even though when I apply for jobs, I get turned down without them even seeing me. So that has nothing to do with anything. Anyway, and there's people here, obviously they don't know the New Zealand culture, because people here are more tattooed than anywhere else I've ever seen, and that includes face tattoos. It's a cultural thing, and while these are not cultural tattoos, it is hardly something to be shocked about. And when my hair is down, as I usually wear it, look, you can't really see anything. Oh no, I've got a couple of tattoos. I'm so stupid. Anyway, so, what was I talking about? There's just so much to say about them. I lose track all the time. Anyway, so I was trying to fix my life. They were trying to talk about me. They couldn't really think of anything. And I was like, you know what? Maybe, just maybe, it's finally over. They've got nothing to say. I'm fixing everything. I did what they wanted me to do. And they've got nothing on me. And so maybe now I can finally live in peace. But at the same time, in the back of my head, I was like, well, what if, what if, what if, what if, what if? They could be watching, they could be out there. If somebody came and insulted me instantly, oh, that's lolcow, and I'd go and I'd check, nope, I haven't seen anything. It's not them. Okay, it was just a one-off. And then I started to relax again. So I Googled myself is what happened, because I was trying to make a point to somebody I was talking to about something that when you Google my name, I'm all over the internet. And even if I shut down my profile, it won't matter because I'm all over the internet. So when I Googled that, I saw, because the first two that pop up are lolcow, and it showed that there was new posts, and I was like, you've got to be shitting me. And I looked and I saw like that, like in real time, as I was posting stuff, they were screenshotting it and taking it. And the shit that they say, like, if you want to see what they're saying, please feel free to go. Because, I mean, you guys might not know because you don't know my life, but the shit that they say is just so stupid. Like, it is just so fucking stupid and far-fetched. And it's like, they're just looking and looking and looking. They think that Logan is unhappy and wants to leave me. They're still on that. He's not going anywhere. Oh, that's what it was I was going to say. They're still debating on why I'm so white, because apparently I photoshopped the shit out of myself. I'm on video and I don't know how to edit video, and I'm still white, and I don't wear white makeup like Black Friday does. I don't wear white. I wear just light or ivory, or classic ivory, because that's a yellow based ivory. Why is she so white? And then they think that I bleach my skin. It's like, I don't go outside. I've been inside for almost 10 years. I leave once a week. And I'm part white. And then they're like, is she really part Asian? Who does she think she's fooling? Oh, blah, blah, blah. Like, they're mad at me because I do my makeup the way that I do, and they think that I'm trying to fool people into thinking I'm not Asian, which is stupid because I tell people I'm Asian and I do my makeup like this because I like it. Like, you see, they just pick and point and poke at everything. And then there was a video, because the thing is, this is a new channel, not old channel. This is a new channel, as I've said at the beginning of the channel. Because of that, I re-uploaded old videos that were on my old channel. Not this channel, re-upload old videos. Got that? Lolcow, understand? Do you understand that this is a new channel, right? So I did not transport all of my videos from my old channel to this channel until a couple weeks ago. So there's a video on there where I have my white wig on, and it was a miscarriage thing. And I just chose things that people had asked me about, talked to me about, had seen and wanted to see again, or that were just part of my life that I feel like, why the fuck should I hide? It was, you know, my YouTube channel is kind of like a living journal for me. I could look back on my videos and be like, oh, I remember that, I remember that, you know. And the things that I don't re-upload are the ones where I'm bashing people, or I'm really negative, or like, I fucking hate this and that, and where I come off as a really ignorant bitch, because I'm not trying to be that person anymore. So those are the videos I left out. Most of the other stuff I re-uploaded. So they're talking about that video, and they're like, did she re-upload that? It says re-upload, but I don't trust it. I think she got pregnant again, and she's talking about her miscarriages because she's an attention whore. And it's like, okay, not only am I much fatter, not only are my tattoos completely different, my face is different, but it says re-upload. You can tell by looking at it that it is an old video, but they're saying that it's a new video and that I've been pregnant and I'm just blasting it to tell everybody. And it's like, they call me an attention whore when I'm just doing my thing, living my life, but they come here and watch everything, and they screenshot everything. And not only do they screenshot it, they download it, they save it, and then they upload it to their own hosts so that I can't get rid of it. And then they follow me on Facebook, and it's like, they are living their lives around my life, but I'm the attention whore. It seems to me like they're giving me attention. I'm not asking for it, but if they want to give me the attention, fine. Like I said, they are making a celebrity out of me in a way, because so many people know who I am now, and it's because of people like that who are talking shit about me, and it might give them something to gossip about, but really at this point, it's like as I was saying, I was waiting for it to come, maybe, and then it came, and I was shocked and like, what the fuck? But I've worked so hard to fix everything. Why can't they see that? And then I went through like a full 24 hours of feeling like that. And then it was like, you know what? Wow. Like the shit that they're saying now is just so rooted in fantasy that it literally is laughable. Now, no fronting, no lying, no pretending it doesn't hurt. After the initial hurt, it doesn't hurt. And so that's why I'm making this video. I know it might sound like a lot of blabbing, but I've just had a lot floating through my head that I want to address. And it's in no particular order. These are just what's in my head, what isn't. You can listen, you cannot listen. Lolcow's gonna be going crazy because there's gonna be like a fucking 40, 45 minute video that they're not gonna want to have the patience to sit through. So they're gonna rely on one of their own to summarize it. When they summarize it, they're going to make fun of me and say, oh, blah, 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 it's more of Raven whining, as if we're gonna listen to it. Like, they like to act all cocky, like, as if we care about her life, meanwhile, they're talking about my life. You know what I mean? Like, it's what they don't realize is that they should have stopped while they were ahead, because there was a point when they really got to me and it was like, wow, this really sucks. But now it's at the point where it's like, wow, this is really stupid, you know? And it is really stupid. Like the shit that they say, like I'm so bad, but they wish death on my unborn babies. Why? Why? 'Cause I was mad at my son and said the wrong thing once. Like you've never said the wrong thing once, saying that you're gonna come and piss and shit on my grave if I killed myself over you, and that you wouldn't have bully's remorse, and if I killed myself, it would be worth it because I'm such an awful person. I think that's way worse than anything I've ever done because you don't even fucking know me. And that I go online and I beg and beg for treats and people to send me stuff, which I never have. And in fact, when people ask me if they can send me stuff, the first thing I do is say no. Oh, that's okay, you don't have to. And I don't expect anybody to, but people like to, and I mean, I appreciate it. And you know, fuck, if people want to do it, then they're gonna do it. And if they offer, they're obviously offering for a reason. And then they are talking shit about the LASIK thing because apparently I'm not allowed to ask for help from my eyes. I should be asking for help from my big fucking nose because I hate my nose so much. And what else? What else? What else? What else? There's something else I was gonna talk about. Oh, and then that the cat and dog situation that I freaked out, and the whole reason it was a mess is because I can't get along with people, and because I expected the cat and dog to come and be fully trained. For one, yeah, I kind of do expect to get a cat and not have it walk around and shit on everything I own. And for two, I expect to have a dog that's not gonna bite my husband, try to kill my other cat, and bite my husband's grandma. And trying to work with the owners and having them start shit and show up at my house at 3 in the morning doesn't mean that I can't get along with people. It means that those assholes have got a problem, but they're just like you. So maybe that's why you think that it's me that has a problem when in reality, it's all of you assholes. So, it's things like that, you know. They take something real and they turn it around and lie and lie and lie and lie and lie and lie and lie. Ooh. What else? They don't have any problem bringing innocent people into their shit because they're so bored and lame that they've got to pick on anybody that crosses their path. Unless that person hates me as well, then suddenly they're BFFs. They're so cool with each other. Oh, and I also wanted to say that another reason that it doesn't bother me anymore is because I have a lot more people on my side that are really fucking cool than I do enemies. And the enemies are a small group of people that go site to site to site to site, They are nameless, they're faceless, they hide, and they're chicken shit liars. They have to lie because there's nothing real that they can talk about. So they've got to take the truth and twist it and turn it and make it suit their twisted, fucked up vision of what they think I am. Whereas in reality, I have a lot of people who I know their face, I know their name, who are on my side. They write to me, they support me, they're always there for me. They've bailed us out, you know. Fucking, I had one really, really nice lady when Logan first lost his job. She sent enough money for us to cover the rent, which is like $350. And this is someone I hadn't even spoken to. And she pretty much helped keep us off the street. And I had another friend, and he helped keep my power on and my phone on and everything because he sent like 200 and something dollars. And then I got like a big box of food. And I mean, when we've been really, really hurting and really down, I've fucking had people have my back. And those people, whether they send money or they send food or they just write me or offer to call me or just an ear online, and they come to me and ask me, how are you doing? If you need to talk, I'm here. And they show their support. Those are the people that matter to me. And I have so much support, people that are real to me because they don't hide. That completely just diminishes the effect that the bullies have. I never really noticed before how much support I had out there because all I ever focused on was the bad stuff because I hated myself so much. But now that I could see things more clearly, I do realize how lucky I am, and I have this extended family out there of amazing people that have lifted me up and held me up when I've needed it the most. And that is what matters. That has more power than all the bullies in the world. So while, in all honesty, from time to time I might be like, whoa, what the fuck? And either react in extreme anger or extreme sadness for the moment, that will quickly fade. And what's left are all these people that hold me up and that are there for me. You know, I'm so lucky. So lucky. And I'm not gonna let a group of faceless, lying, wannabe bullies take that away from me. You know, I don't know what you get out of this and why you're so focused on my life. Like, is it really because you want Logan? You think he's sexy? You think you've got a chance with him? Because if you take apart everything you guys pick on, let's take it apart quickly. One, I'm almost 40 and I look alternative. Okay, how many people in the world are my age and look like me or worse? How bad is that in the grand scheme of things, seriously? And how does that affect you or anybody else? I don't work. I used to work, and I've tried working since I've been here, and I've got medical reasons why I cannot work, and my husband is fine with me not working. Again, how does that affect you again? And why is that such a bad thing? Am I the only one of you that doesn't work? Seriously, most of you probably don't have a job because if you did, you wouldn't have all the time to dedicate to watching my life. Don't you have families or something? Three, I've lost my shit at my son and I've said things the wrong way, but it's been years since I've done that. You guys have never said anything wrong, ever, to anybody? Come on. You say shit wrong on this site all the time. I've seen the shit you've said. I've seen the shit you've done. You're no fucking angel and you're nobody to fucking talk down to me for making a mistake. I made a mistake. I made up for it. Fucking let it go. Get over yourself and leave me alone about it. It doesn't affect my son anymore. He's here for a reason. He's here because he wants to be here. Blah, blah, blah. Not your life. Blah, blah, blah. Again, a mistake that many people have made, nothing out of the ordinary. I have married somebody younger than me. In this country, 16 is the legal age. There is no minimum age for guys. You can date a guy of any age. That is a pretty fucked up thing, but that's just the way it is. The thing here is for guys that are in their 20s to fuck 15-year-olds. 16 is too old for them. They like them 14 to 15. They like to just fuck them Use them, fuck them, and ditch them. One guy that was actually bullying me over being with Logan is in prison right now for fucking a 15-year-old, and he's like in his 30s. And she turned him in for statutory rape because she's a fucking whore. The kids here are very loose and they like fuck as a pastime because there's nothing else to do. At least in this city, that's what they're like. What I have done by getting together with him is different because I didn't get with him just for sex. I got with him because I love him and I was, highly attracted to him. But it wasn't one-sided. It wasn't me that chased him down. I didn't pressure him. I didn't make him be with me. I didn't do anything of the sort. I was introduced to him. I didn't want to get with him. I tried to leave him. I said, I don't want to take your youth away. I don't want to take your life away. I want you to be able to live life and experience life and not be tied down with me. He wants what he wants and he wanted me, still wants me. Get over it. So all things considered, even that's not bad because it was a mutual decision. And as many times as I try to leave him, he doesn't want it. It is not up to you. It is not up to his parents. It is not up to anybody else. It is up to him and to me. His family has accepted me. He's accepted me, and that's all that really matters. And you might think 16 is too young, and you know what? Maybe it is, but I'm not exactly your typical, like, almost 40-year-old either. I don't think like it. I don't feel like it. I'm not trying to hold on to my youth. This is just how I am. Don't know why. I'm kind of frozen in time. Can't be with someone my age. Not because I'm so fucked in the head, but because I've got nothing in common with people my age. It's not because I'm cray cray or whatever. It's because I've got nothing in common with them and I'm not attracted to older guys. I can't see myself as that old. I really don't. Don't know why. I just don't. Never will, probably. And it just doesn't work. He was legal when I got with him. And, everybody says, well, if he was at least 18, it wouldn't be so bad. Well, you know what? He's about to turn 21 and you're still on his case. Like, he's stupid or something and he's a hostage and he looks so upset. And it's just, oh, why? Again, why? And not to mention, it changes through history. Back in the day, if you weren't married by like 18, you were considered an old maid over the hill. 21, forget it. You're like, your youth is basically behind you. So, through the times, it's basically what society says is right. As long as both people go into it with their eyes open, both people are willing, and both people want it, I don't see what the problem is. I don't. Oh, and then you pick on me because I've got BPD and because I said I might have Asperger's. Apparently, I'm not allowed to self-diagnose myself. That's something that I fucked up on. Oh shit. Because people had told me. Ugh. Sorry, I just ate. People had told me they thought I had it. And I was like, psh, I don't fucking have that. I'm not fucking autistic and blah, 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 blah. And as always, I shoot it down. And then somebody from here was like, look, my daughter has this. My husband has this. Here are some links. You should just look into it. And I don't know why, it was just like the BPD thing. I decided to look into it, and so I did. Once I looked into it, I was like, holy hell, this actually kind of fits. And from there, the next logical step is to get more information on it and to ask if anybody has experience with it that might see that in me, because it costs a lot of money to get seen for it. So I kind of wanted to get some feedback on it before booking an appointment. I'm not just gonna sit back and say, "Oh God, all these problems, help me, I'm fucked up." No, I'm gonna find out what might be wrong with me so that I can go to a professional and see if I actually do have this wrong with me. And not saying that it'll change anything in my life, but I'm always up for learning about myself. And if I learn something about myself, I might be able to find tricks or techniques to feel more normal, you know? Because as it is, I don't really feel like I fit in at all, and it confuses me. I don't understand what makes me so different, what makes me a target, what makes everything different. I don't understand it. And so I'm always looking for answers, which I don't see anything wrong with. And again, it doesn't hurt anybody. Not looking for excuses or easy ways out, just looking for feedback before I take the next step and spend money we don't have. As far as I know, that's about everything that they talk about, aside from, you know, my nose and my weight, which am I really supposed to jump and get plastic surgery because they say they don't like something about me? I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't want to keep repeating myself, but basically, I think I'm long past the point of being hurt now. It's kind of like a laxative effect, like, oh, this shit's out now. You know, I know that they've latched onto something else and they're talking shit and they're gonna be talking shit, and so that's kind of out in the open now. The thing that I've been dreading and waiting for, it's happened, and so there's nothing else to say. This is just a kind of look, I know you're there, and I know you're watching, and I know that you're full of shit. And if you really think that that's reality, you should seriously get yourself checked out because it's not even close to reality. You don't matter to me. I am happy with myself now. I am not the same person I was when you started picking on me. And whether you think I've changed or not, that's irrelevant. What matters is what I think, first of all, what my family thinks, second of all, and then all the support I have, third of all. And you don't factor into any of that. And no longer am I going to be restricting myself based on being scared of what you're going to see or what you're going to save. I do hide links. I post shit and then I hide it, but I've always done that. It doesn't mean I think it's wrong. It's like if I post something and it gets ignored, I'm like, oh, maybe it was stupid and I'll just hide it. I don't know. I just do. Or if I post it and it's misspelled, or I post it and then I don't like it, I'm like, oh, I'll just fucking hide it. Or I'll put it something up for a little while and then it's not relevant anymore. Like the video Dorian and Logan asking for questions. They've made that video already and it's scheduled to be released, and so the thing of them asking for questions is irrelevant now, and so I've hidden it. I mean, I do that. It has nothing to do with you. You guys are pompous, conceited assholes, and you think the world revolves around you and your opinion, and you're lonely losers. And so what you do is you gather together with other pathetic, lonely losers, and you talk shit about me and other people out there, picking apart anybody, skinny people, pretty people, famous people, not famous people. It doesn't matter who it is. Nobody is safe from you guys. You guys are just a bunch of gossipy little bitches that sit around talking shit about people because you've got no life and you've got no power over me anymore. You're probably not going to have watched this, but I hope you do, but you probably won't. Keep on watching my life, please, by all means. What is there to be online for if nobody's gonna watch you? You know, I mean, all attention is still attention, regardless. I don't think I'm gonna check back anymore because you guys are so fucking boring. You're just saying the same shit over and over and over again. If anything changes and you come up with something original or good, then let me know and then maybe I'll go back and check it. But until then, it's just not really worth it. It's just like, you know, if I wanted to read a fairy tale, I've got a book actually sitting over there of fairy tales that are far more entertaining than watching like a bunch of gossipy hens just sitting there yapping about my life. And it's just like, what the fuck? It's like, I'm surprised you don't say that, you know, I'm a white-haired black man, because that's how opposite the shit actually is that you guys are trying to say about me. And oh, you make fun of my wedding because it looks so cheap and my dress looks so shit. I don't care. Were you there? Were you the one getting married? No. I loved it. So what the fuck does it matter to me if you didn't love it? I probably hate you and the way you look, and that's why you fucking hide. God, like, you guys need to get over yourself. You think that your opinion is the only opinion in the world that matters, and your opinion doesn't mean shit to anybody but others like you, and that's why you have to gather with others like you because you've got nobody and you never will. And I'm so happy to get this out. Like, I feel so good, not only about myself, but just to be able to say this and just be like, God, you're fucking stupid. And if I could sit there and tell every single one of you personally how stupid I think you are, I totally would, because I think that you guys are all stupid. You're stupid, you're liars, you're pathetic, you're full of shit, you're full of yourself, and you've got to put others down to make yourselves feel better because you've got nothing. And you can't say, I don't know shit, because I know, because I've been there. I was like you for the longest time, which is probably what drew your attention to me on the site that whatever I was on before I was even on lolcow. Because of Logan, because apparently somebody on my friends list didn't like me and the way I acted, and so they started posting about me on all these other sites, and then those sites got shut down, and then it went on to lolcow. And it's like, there are so many people out there that are worse than me, that talk worse than me, that act worse than me, but I'm the target. And you know what? If that's my lot in life, then so be it. I'm not gonna fight it anymore. If your every waking moment and thought is, what is she doing? Are her and Logan split up yet? Has her son left her yet? Oh my God, is she dead yet? Please keep giving me views and attention and keep coming and checking on me. I'll be here. I'm not going anywhere. And I'm over you and I'm over your shit. And I know you've got so much that you're gonna talk about. Like, I've probably given you, like, what's that fucking word? Anyway, I've probably given you enough shit to use against me for the next year with this video. So it'll be kind of funny to see you, like, arguing amongst yourself. Not see, because I'm not gonna check, but I'll know that that's what you're doing. It'll be humorous to me to imagine you guys arguing amongst yourselves and being like, oh, she said this. Oh, she said that. Did you watch that video? I didn't watch that video. Oh, it was too fucking long. She needs to shut the fuck up. Oh, look at her. Look at her makeup. Oh, look at her hair. Did she get fat again? Oh, I'm waiting for this. Did Logan leave her yet? You know? You're like a broken record, but yeah, it'll be really funny because this is so long and I know you're not gonna want to sit through it all and you're not gonna like know what's said in the middle, and I know your curiosity is going to get the better of you, and you've got to decide whether you want to listen to the whole thing or skip over it or not. And you're going to say you didn't listen to it, but in reality I think you will. And so here's a secret. I make a lot of my videos longer now on purpose just because I know you guys will sit through the whole thing because you're so fucking nosy. So I was originally trying to make my videos shorter. And then I was like, well, I remembered back to when I would sit there and talk about stuff, and then they'd be like, God, it's a 10-minute video. I don't want to listen to that shit. And then get like so bored and not want to listen to it. And, you know, so I was like, okay, so I'll make longer videos. And if I say anything stupid, it'll be in the middle somewhere. So they have to have watched the whole thing to get to it. Didn't think that would happen. Then it turned out it did happen with that 50 question one, where I mentioned Logan working a lot. And I keep forgetting on that topic, they are also saying that all I'm doing is bitching and whining about how we have no money and how we're broke. And I said that once in one video, and it was the update that he lost his job and that we're having a hard time. I haven't said it since then. What I've said since then or before then was that I usually can't afford makeup and stuff because it's very expensive. Somebody said, go to Farmers, check out Essence Makeup because they're very cheap. I did that, found some, got a review coming up on that. Okay, that's cool. And then with the job that he was bringing home like $1,300 a week. So that was a lot of money. And with that money, I was getting makeup. I got Monster High dolls. I got Ever After dolls. I got Pop Funkos. I have haul videos galore coming up. They're all scheduled. And this is all when we had quite a bit of fucking money. And so when he lost his job, we went from having all this money to having nothing once I said that. But apparently that's all I've talked about. And then I show videos where I have all this stuff, even though every video is started with, "These are recorded out of order. All my videos are scheduled." They're so stupid. They just don't understand English. No habla inglés. What are you doing on YouTube, bitches? Anyway, so everything's out of order, but I've got stuff coming up, from when we still had money. And then he had gotten his holiday pay that we were not expecting because he said he wasn't entitled to it, but I guess his old boss was being nice or something, and he gave it to him. And with that, we had one last haul, which was some makeup from the site that had shit for like at American prices. Like, this is Lip Tar, this is Pagan, so it's like this pretty purple, and this was $7.99, so quite cheap. So I've got not only a review coming up of that site and the stuff I've got, like a haul, but I've also got doing full makeup with the new stuff. So I do have stuff coming up, but again, things are out of order. So, God, man, just get your facts straight. Do you think you would have anything real to talk about with me if you actually told the truth for once? Or, really, like, if you're so certain that I'm such a bad person, then why don't you try telling the truth for once and actually telling it like it is instead of embellishing all your stories about me and making shit up? And then the people that read it are so ignorant that they're just following the lies and they don't know their head from their ass, and neither do you. And I keep repeating this shit, and I don't even know if you're gonna be watching this, but there's my secret. I make my videos long on purpose just to give my stalkers a little bit of a challenge because I know they hate listening to my long videos. Anybody out there that has problems with bullies, please, please, please take my videos to heart. And if you need any help at all, feel free to write me. Don't message me on YouTube because I don't get notification. You can email me. My email's listed on the page. I'm here for you guys. Whatever you need, I'm here for you. All joking aside, bullying is very serious and it is very hard to get over. You have to be in the right mindset and you have to be really, really confident and strong in yourself to be able to see past their bullshit. But no matter how strong you are or how confident you are, there will be times when somebody will say just the right thing and it'll just be like, what? Seriously? And maybe it'll hit you on a day when you're just feeling depressed or you're moody or you're hormonal, who knows? And the right thing said could have a really devastating effect on you in general, and it could eat away at you. You've just got to be really strong. And in my case, the fact that they're lying about me so much is what is making me stronger, because the shit they say is just so, it's just so fantastic. Like, not, yeah, fantastic, but just like fantasy. So much fantasy, you can't help but laugh. And so that's where I get my strength, aside from reinventing myself again or whatever. The fact is that when I see what they say and I see just the blatant lies, I just sit there like, how do they come up with this shit? Like, seriously, some of the shit that they say, I bleach my skin, my husband's ready to leave, he's tucking money away, I keep him hostage, and anything he does because I make him or whatever. I don't even know. Like, it's just everything they say is just so fucked. And the fact that they take my literal words and they change them and they misquote me and bring up shit that happened so many years ago as if it was even relevant now, and they use that to keep their hate site about me going because they've got no real reason to be on me. they're reaching, and they're reaching because they're desperate. And that shit is what makes me laugh, you know. Someone that's so confident, so overly confident that they're in the right, but yet they can't even have the balls to show their face. I mean, what's not to laugh at, you know? So just think of it that way. I mean, every bit of bullying is different, but if you get bullying like me, if I didn't hate them so much, I would pity them, but I hate them so much, I don't pity them at all. I just like wish them all a horrible death. But aside from that, they're not gonna get to me. Those days are long done, and I'm quite happy to say that those days are way over. And I hope I didn't put you guys to sleep. You good guys and you lolcow fuckers. Can you like please play in traffic or something? Anyway, thanks for watching all the way to the end. I know this was a hard one, but I had a lot to say. And thank you so much for being there for me, one way or the other, being there with me, being against me or for me, it doesn't matter, it's all entertaining in the end. I'm still here, I'm not going anywhere, and I hope you guys have a great day. Not you, lolcow people, you can, again, you can die. You other people, I hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you around, and take care. I'd be very eager to see your comments, like, shut the fuck up, this is so long. And yeah, so shorter videos coming, not very short, but a little bit shorter than this. And lots of good stuff in the future, and I hope to see you guys then. Take care. Bye-bye. Don't let the bullies get you down. Bullies, man, need to get a life. 'Cause you guys can't have my life. It's mine and I love it.